Today is the day where we will actually work with the unit. Teeny tiny.
Teeny tiny, compact.
We turn it on. And you may just want to push the button. Just for...
That's it?
Yeah. It's an implemented countdown so that you can get out of the way.
Yeah.
The mirror will start spinning. That creates a laser beam that spins around and rotates around its axis there that captures the 3D information.
It's silent.
And it's pretty silent, isn't it?
It's amazing, yeah.
You're literally nothing. Here. How many points is this capturing?
It'll capture 360,000 points per second.
Now, if this gives me a three-dimensional point cloud of the spaces that we're working in, and I can just open that up and look without having to call up the client, and make that infamous phone call, hey, I missed something, and you come back. It saves me the embarrassment, and it also, you know, we look more professional.
While it's capturing the data, data is already being transferred to the iPad, and you'll see the image build up as you take the images, so you have immediate feedback about what's going on.
And so you get to interact with that data as soon as it comes.
The operation's pretty simple, just touch new scan. So this is the live view, so you see the photos coming in real time. So this is nice as kind of a, just a really quick, as soon as it starts, you can see what you're getting.
Yeah, they look good.
And what's the average time on a scan usually?
3 minutes total capture.
Total capture that includes images and scan.
And there's no limitation to the number of setups I can do?
Really just the amount of memory you have on your iPad. And there's a fixed amount on here, but it's pretty large.
Will you have a web link that we could share out of the photo tour?
Absolutely.
Yeah. That'd be nice.
So, would you guys like to see the data off of it?
Absolutely.
Timed on my phone, it was about 15 minutes to get from our last scan to this. From there, there's a step to create the point cloud, and when that's done, you'll see this. There's all kinds of different ways you can color the data. So this is just by elevation. You can get a little more detail with it and see flatness variations. All these tools are available on the iPad or immediately once you've made this point cloud. I can mark all my stuff for demo and then make a set of views that show each of those with just that on, and then I could have another set of markups for installation notes or something. You can make those views with those annotations right there while you're taking the next scan or whatever.
I can put notes saying, hey, this is what they want, and this is where they want it, and have pretty much a defined
that's the idea.
Outline of design by the time I get back to the office.
That's exactly. The idea is that anything that you know when you're out there scanning, you can attach to that.
This is going to make it easier on the folks that go in the field and actually do the scanning because it's lighter, quicker.
If this does it in a lot less time and I get more information, everybody's happy.